Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Transmission for you today. It is the 22nd day of February on this Tuesday edition, 2011. And obviously, oil has shot up by 9 percentage points in just the last few hours as the turmoil in the Middle East intensifies. And many political analysts in the United States, Europe, and Russia are saying they believe that the Middle East now faces decades of turmoil. In fact, the Russian president, Medvedev, sees, quote, fires for decades in Arab world. And the Muslim Brotherhood is trying to overthrow Gaddafi. It appears that it was probably disinformation put out by British intelligence and the Muslim Brotherhood. It came out of the British Foreign Office that Muammar Gaddafi had fled yesterday to Venezuela and Hugo Chavez's hermitage that he has there. There are confirmed reports of helicopters and fighter aircraft bombing and strafing the protesters. And regardless of what side you sit on, the media is calling them protesters. They are people engaged in insurrection to overthrow the government. Muammar Gaddafi is a dictator. He is a thug. He is a socialist. He is a funder of terrorists, real terrorists, back in the day. Not the staged terrorist. But that does not mean that we're going to get something better there, because when the globalist unseen hand is involved in something, you better believe there's a larger reason that it's happening. So, yeah, good. Get rid of Hosni Mubarak. Get rid of Muammar Gaddafi. Get rid of the Saudi royal family. Get rid of all of these hereditary dictatorships or these dictatorial systems. But at the same time, we have to look at the larger issue that it's about bringing the world into turmoil. In many of these countries, what the media calls Muslim extremists are going to be going into power. And you have to ask, why do the globalists want that? They're going to set up their own form of tyranny. And that appears to be where it's leaning. And most political scientists say that that's going to be the outcome in most of these countries. So I don't shed any tears for Hosni Mubarak, but he's gone. Same military junta that took over 30-plus years ago has now just stepped into his place. So he goes away, has a convenient stroke, kind of like the dictator of Tunisia, and more of the same comes in, and it's celebrated by Anderson, admitted CIA Cooper, that this is just absolute heavenly Valhalla, and that we should all just be celebrating the incredible freedom of the Middle East, with George Soros and his operatives in the State Department all over it and bragging. In fact, Google is bragging that they're helping run these operations. Well, of course, Google's NSA, CIA, information warfare system. Now, here's a headline out of Reuters. Russia blames Google for stirring Egyptian unrest. Well, they sent their people in to do it. It's not debated. Kind of like that headline yesterday, the widow of that top-level former Bush administration official who was shot dead and then thrown in a trash can. And then the headline is, she claims a hitman killed him. Well, no, I mean, he was murdered. He was killed. I mean, the guy sat on the boards of more than 30. I read the list on air a few weeks ago. What was his name? Wheeler? I got to pull it back up. The point is, he sat on all these giant Fortune 500 boards. He was involved in all these different serious operations, and he's disheveled, running around town without a shoe for a day, obviously running for his life, under surveillance. And, well, I'm already digressing. It's just, that's how they spin it. It's like, Russia says Google's involved. Google says they're involved. The woman says a hitman killed her husband. He was hit. It was a professional hit. He was thrown in a dumpster. And there's no investigation. It's just, we don't even know if he was killed. Yeah, he was murdered, but we don't know if it's a hitman. We'll be right back with all this incredible news. Lindsay Williams coming up, by the way.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator.
Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Diamond Gusset is proud to announce the anthem of the Patriot Movement. They're offering a free CD, T-shirt, and bumper sticker with a qualifying purchase. Diamond Gusset offers great products at great prices while keeping Americans working.
I'm looking for a factory where a man can feed his family. Not worried about them moving it south, closing the doors and shutting her down tomorrow. I'm looking for America.
Wear American and be proud. Go to gusset.com/America.
The land of the free and the home of the brave. Seems like I just woke up one day and it was gone. Long gone. But I know in my heart it's still
again. Go to gusset.com/America today.
Alex told you the government announced recently that the recession is over. It ended on June of 2009. The millions of Americans unable to find work might not agree. Perhaps the recession ended for the bankers and government employees, but for the rest of us, things seem to be getting worse. Gold and silver haven't heard the news either. They've begun their long-expected journey to the moon. In addition to converting your shrinking dollars into gold and silver, you should consider a food savings account from eFoods Direct. They both make fabulous investments. Food is our greatest dependency, and we know it will be more precious than any financial resource. You and your family need food to survive a crisis, and you can't eat paper, stocks, or metals. Alex has been urging you to invest in delicious, easy-fix meals to enjoy now or save for long-term. This will freeze the cost of your food while you can still afford it. Visit eFoodsDirect.com on the internet or call 800-409-5633. That's eFoodsDirect.com or 800-409-5633.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
All right, we're going to cover the incredible ongoing developments in the Middle East and North Africa, the response in Europe, the response in the United States, in Russia to it, the incredible effects it's having. With one-day oil prices going up by 9% in one day on fears of what's happening in Libya, what's happening in Bahrain, what's happening in Saudi Arabia, Jordan, what's happening in several other countries.